Hello everyone, and welcome back to another Rhino tutorial. I'm Thomas, and today we will get to know how to create more complex geometry in Rhino. We will dive in right away and start with a new Rhino file. We go to the perspective and start by drawing a rectangle. You can type in the measurements. We will start with 13 times 21 meters. And what we want to do now is we want to copy it upwards. To do this, we use the command copy, select the rectangle, and now we want to copy it straight upwards. To do this, we can use the command option vertical. Yes, and now it will copy the geometries only upwards or downwards. To grab our geometry, we will activate the object snap we already know from the last tutorial, right here at the status bar, and we make sure the endpoints are checked. Now we can grab the endpoint of this line of the rectangle. It will only copy upwards and type in how much we want to move it up. We want to move 21 meters, enter, and leave the command. So now we want to rotate our upper rectangle just a bit. To do this, we use the command rotate, select our object, and now we need to find the center of our rotation. Of course, we want to use the center of our rectangle, and to find it, we can also use the object snap. If we look down here, we see the possibility to snap to the center of an object. We activate it, select our object, and it automatically snaps in the middle of this very object. We click, have defined our center of rotation, and to now type in the degree of rotation. We don't want to rotate very much, so we just do like 20 degrees. And what we will do now is a so-called loft. A loft is a command that fits a surface through selected profile curves that define the surface shape. In this case, our drawn rectangles are our profile curves. So we type in loft, select our curves, and press enter. Confirm once again, click OK, and we created our first loft. Can be seen better in the shaded viewpoint. But you may have already realized there are a few more loft options on the way. So we try some more. We just copy our rectangles to the side to generate some more options. You see, in this basic loft, Rhino connects this starting point or this endpoint of the rectangle with this endpoint and goes in the direction of these little arrows to the next point and connects it with the next point of the upper rectangle, and so on and so on. What we can do now is we can change the seam, the starting point of this loft, by clicking right here and just drag it along the curve. If we do it like this, Rhino will now connect this first point with this point, the second point with this second point, and so on. How does it look? Just confirm it. And now in this drop-down menu, we can define in which style the sections between the connection points will be generated. We'll stay with straight sections for this one. Click OK. And now our geometry is much more twisted in itself. Another thing we can do is Instead of changing the scene of the loft, we can just change the direction the points are connected with each other. You see these small arrows right here? They identify in which direction Rhino counts the connection points. So if we just activate this command option flip and select the right scene, it automatically flips in the other direction. So what will it look like? We just try. And you see it's intersecting with itself and is much more complicated. When lofting, we can of course always use the other command options. We could use the automatic option, where Rhino attempts to align the seams and directions without intersections, which would look like this. Or we can use the natural command option, which will always put the seam where it was at the beginning of the command. In this case, it's the same. So let's say these are our possible buildings, and they are all like 21 meters high, but have only one large room. And now we want to add some floors. The command we can use to do this is called contour. We will choose a new layer to keep it in a good structure and choose the command contour. This command will create a series of planar curves which result from the intersection of cutting planes with your geometry. We choose our building or our surface we want to contour and type it in. We now have to draw the cutting planes normal. This defines the direction in which we will be cutting. We want to cut in a plane level, so our normal vector has to be that axis. To draw this vector, we will just draw a line from the center of the lower rectangle to the upper rectangle. So we keep object snap activated, go from this center point to this center point and create a straight line upwards. Now all we have left to do is to define the distance between the contouring planes. Let's say we want the floor to be 3 meters, we type in 3, and Rhino automatically generates our contour curves. Looks nice, right? We of course can do this with every kind of geometry, as complex as they might be. For example, this one. Will be cut in the same way as our previous geometry. This command doesn't actually cut our geometry, but just creates the intersection curves. As the curves are no floors, we still have to create them. We do this by selecting the curves on this layer. Now we type in planar surface, which creates a planar surface within every planar, of course, closed curve. We confirm and created all our floors. If you want to know how this will be applied to an actual building, stay tuned for the second part of this tutorial.